Good morning, dear parents. In the last video, we have learned about the heating effect of electric current and we have solved a number of problems. Today, let us learn some practical applications of heating effect of electric current. Practical applications of heating effect of electric current. When the current flows through the appliances, like electrical appliances, heating is inevitable. It is inevitable. When the current flows through appliances like bulb, like fan, after some time, you see the bulb becomes very hot and the fan surface, after some time you touch it, it becomes very hot. It is basically due to the energy that is supplied by the source to drive the current through the appliances. The part of that energy is converted into heat. The work done in driving the charges, work done in pumping the charges through the appliances, part of it is converted into unavoidable, undesirable heat. For example, in case of bulb, or in case of fan, or for that matter, any electrical gadget, the heat is undesirable, but it is inevitable. It is because of conversion of the electrical energy, part of electrical energy into heat energy. But today we are learning about the useful applications of heating effect of electric current. We use electric iron, electric laundry iron for pressing the clothes. There it is desirable, it requires. The electrical energy must be converted into heat energy. In the same way, electric kettle, electric geyser, we can give examples, electric heater. So these are all the examples of heating effect of electric current. Electric heater, electric toaster. You can give examples. Electric toaster, electric heater, electric iron. Right? So you can give number of examples which are converting electrical energy into heat energy. Electric kettle. So in all these devices, etc., electric energy, that is electricity, is converted into heat energy. So here a particular alloy is used as a heating element. The heating element used here is in all these devices is nichrome, as I have told you earlier. It's an alloy. It has a high resistance and a high value of temperature coefficient, high value of resistivity. So that when the energy is, the work is done in driving the charges, or the work that is done in driving the current through such a coil of a toaster or heater or iron, electric iron or kettle, that electric energy is converted into heat, in the form of heat. That heat is utilized for useful purposes. Now, one more device that commonly used is electric bulb. Electric bulb is mainly meant for lighting purposes. We want light from the electric bulb, we don't want heat. So, here electric energy is converted into heat energy. Electric energy must be converted into light energy. But in addition to light energy, you will find heat energy also. This heat energy is undesirable, but it is unavoidable. it is inevitable. How does the electric bulb give us light? The electric bulb, you know, consists of tungsten filament. Electric bulb consists of tungsten filament. Electric bulb, we are speaking about the filament bulb. It consists of a strong metal, tungsten. Tungsten filament. Which is having very high temperature, high melting point. It has a high melting point. The melting point of this tungsten filament is 3380 degrees centigrade. So easily doesn't melt easily. So this tungsten filament, which is taken in the glass case, glass bulb, must be heated very strongly. When the current passes through the bulb filament is heated very strongly. Not only red hot, it becomes white hot. When it becomes white hot, it gives out light in addition with heat, because it is already heated. So it gives out heat as well as light. But more than the light, it gives us heat. Right? So in order to give off the useful energy light, and in order to maintain that filament without melting, without rising it to a temperature greater than melting point, this filament is taken in a glass bulb filled with rare gases like argon gas. Bulb filled with argon and nitrogen gas. So argon and nitrogen gases are not reactive. They are almost like what you call inert gases. They do not react. They do not help for the burning. They do not help for oxidation. If ordinary air is there, then filament will readily burn, because ordinary air consists of oxygen, which helps for combustion, which helps for burning. So that should not take place. Therefore, the bulb is filled with argon and nitrogen gas. This mixture will not allow the bulb, it will not allow the filament to burn, and the bulb will not fuse. Right? So this is the another application of the practical applications of heating effect of electric current. So electric toaster, electric heater, electric laundry iron, electric kettle, and these are, even heater is also called as electric geyser. These are all the practical applications of electric heating effect of electric current. For lighting effect of electric current, we use electric bulb and we use tube light. Tube light is an incandescent, tube light is a fluorescent bulb, tube, it is called fluorescent tube. In that, heating doesn't take place to that extent, so much of extent that takes place in the electric bulb, that much of heating doesn't take place. So if you touch the tube light surface, you will not find it hot. So it is called fluorescent tube. So there is a discharge of electricity through the gases. Discharge of electricity through the gases take place, and thus electric energy is converted into light energy. Right? This is the example of conversion of electrical energy into light energy. So in this, electric energy is converted into light energy plus unavoidable heat energy. The heat energy is because the filament is heated very strongly. When it is heated very strongly, white hot, it gives us light. Now one more practical application is electric fuse. Electric fuse is a safety device. This also works on the principle of heating effect of electric current. Works on principle of heating effect of electric current. The electric fuse is a safety device.
Is a safety device.
It is always connected with the live wire for the main circuit. From the main circuit, it is connected to the live wire. So that in case of voltage fluctuations, in case of current fluctuations, in case of short circuits, suddenly when the high current flows, then this fuse readily melts. This fuse melts and breaks the circuit. See, this electric fuse is made up of a material having low melting point. It must be a good conductor.
A good conductor. It must be a good conductor having low melting point.
So that even if high current flows due to fluctuations, due to short circuit, if the high current flows suddenly into the circuit, this electric fuse melts and circuit is cut, the circuit is broken, and all the electrical gadgets in our home will be safe. We are using refrigerator, we are using mixer grinder in the kitchen, we are using electric oven. Electric oven is also heating effect of electric current. Is an example of heating effect of electric current. Electric oven, fans we are using TVs, we are using computers, so many electrical gadgets, right? AC device, all these air conditioning units, these are all being used. So in order to keep them safe, a safety device is used. This is electric fuse. It works on the principle of heating effect of electric current. It must be a good conductor having low melting point. So in order to get this property, it is usually made up of alloy. It is an alloy made up of lead and tin. Lead and tin is an alloy made up of lead and tin, so that it has a low melting point and melts readily. Lead is a good conductor. Right? So thus it saves all the devices in the circuit. Now, this electric fuse you must have seen in the circuit. It is taken in a porcelain case. Nowadays, electric fuse are available in the form of cartridge tubes. So different electric fuses are used for different electrical appliances based on their heating capability, based on their amount of current that they can draw, right? So usually 5 ampere current limiting value of 5 ampere current is used for the home appliances. For electric appliances like electric iron, electric heater, and electric oven, geyser, kettle, it requires more current. Therefore, the fuse for those will be of the form of cartridge tube, and they will be capable of holding more current. So they will be having different values of current. Let us see, for example, if we want to calculate the current that can be drawn from a electric laundry iron. Suppose the electric laundry iron is having a power of 1 kilowatt. 1 kilowatt means 1000 watt. So how much of a current it draws? Based on that, a fuse is being used. Let us see how much current it draws. So electric fuse is a device by which the maximum limit of the current to be passed through an electric circuit is controlled. So, the electric fuse is an alloy made up of lead and tin, or copper and tin, or aluminium and tin. Lead, copper, aluminium, these are all good conductors. Right? If it is mixed with the tin, it is an alloy. Right? So, when excessive current flows through this alloy fuse, then it melts down readily, and
the circuit is broken. When the circuit is broken, all the devices are safe. Let us see how much is the limiting value of current for an electric iron.
For an electric iron, of 1000 watt power,
it is written on the electric heater or electric kettle or electric iron. What is its power? Let us say there is an electric iron of power 1000 watt, 1 kilowatt is also written as 1 kW, means 1 kilowatt,
for connected in a circuit of 220 volt supply. It requires the current passing through this can be calculated.
The current
I passing through it, the current that can allow is I equal to P by V, where P is power, P is equal to VI, P equal to VI, therefore I is equal to P by V. So P is 1000 watt divided by volt 220. So if you cancel, so 100 by 22, it comes out to be 88, you are left with 12, 22 5 110. So 4.54 amperes. So a current fuse having same material, cartridge means a tube like fuse with glass casing, which is having lead and tin inside, lead and tin wire inside. It's a piece of wire, it's a piece of wire. Cartridge fuse having 5 ampere current limit. 5 ampere current limit is used for as a safety fuse for this. So like that, depending on the power of electrical appliances, the safety fuse of different limiting value of current are used. In case due to short circuit, if the current exceeds more than 5 ampere, then this fuse melts down and the current supplied to the electric iron is stopped, and thus electric iron, the device is safe. Devices are safe. Based on the wattage, based on the power of the electrical devices, this kind of cartridge fuses are being used. You can check in your home appliances. Cartridge fuse will be there for every device. Okay, now let us learn another important thing. I have used here the term electric power. What is electric power? The rate of being work, the rate of electric energy supplied with respect to time is called as electric power. Work done per unit time is called as power. So in terms of electric power, electric work done, that is work done in supplying the electric current through a device per unit time, that gives us electric power. So we define electric power as time rate of work done, or time rate of doing work, or time rate at which electric energy being consumed. The rate of energy consumed with respect to time is called as electric power. So we know work done in driving the current I through a potential difference V for a time t is given by VIT. We have discussed this in the previous video. So work done per unit time uses electric power. Therefore, electric power supplied to a device is given by work done by time taken, or energy supplied or energy consumed per unit time. So that is VIT divided by T. So if you cancel T, you are getting V into I. So thus we get electric power P is equal to VI. The product of voltage and current itself gives us the electric power. For example, there is an electric bulb of 100 watt. You must have seen the bulbs, 100 watt bulb, 40 watt bulb, 40 watt tube lights, 20 watt tube lights. Nowadays LED bulbs are available, 8 watt LED bulb, 4 watt LED bulb, 10 watt LED bulb, 15 watt LED bulbs, right? So you are getting various types of electrical devices having their own power, energy consumed per second, right? So if there is a bulb of 100 watts connected to a 220 volt mains supply, then how much current it draws? If you want to calculate, bulb of 100 watt power, 100 watt power connected to a source of 220 volt, source of 220 volt supply draws a current. How much current it draws? This can be very easily calculated using this equation. We have P equal to VI, power P equal to VI. This implies I is equal to P by V. P is 100 watts and voltage is 220. So 10 by 22, that is 5 by 11. 5 by 11. So if you calculate this, it comes out to be about 0.4. 0.4 5 amperes. 11 4s are 44, 6 remains, 11 5s are 54. 0.45 amperes. So this is how we calculate the current drawn from a device having certain wattage. Now another unit of the power is in terms of work done per time. Work done per time is what? Joule per second. Right? So SI unit of power, you know, SI unit of power, electric power is watt. This is the famous scientist James Watt, in the honor of James Watt, who has followed steam engine, modified steam engine having a high efficiency. In his honor, the SI unit of power is named as watt. In short, it is written as capital W. So it means 1 watt equal to 1 joule per second. It means if 1 joule of electric work is done, if 1 joule of electric energy is supplied per second in an electric circuit, in an electric device, then 1 watt is the power supply. The power supply is 1 watt. 100 watt, what does it mean? The 100 watt bulb consumes 100 joules of electric energy per second. 50 watt or 40 watt bulb, 40 watt bulb, what does it mean? It consumes 40 joules of electric energy per second. 1000 watt electric iron, 1000 watt electric iron means it consumes 1000 joules of electric energy per second. In order to drive the electric charges through that nichrome coil, you need a work of 1000 joules per second. That is the meaning of 1000 watt. Let us solve some problems so that you can understand the meaning of the watt, the SI unit of power. SI unit of power is watt. Let us solve simple problems. An electric motor takes 5 ampere of electric current from 220 volt supply. Determine the power of the motor and the energy consumed in 2 hours. There are two things to be calculated. What is the power of the motor and what is the energy consumed by that motor when it is switched on for 2 hours. These are the two things for 2 hours. Right? First, power consumed. Power of the motor. So directly we can calculate P equal to VI. P equal to VI, right? V is 220. The current is 5 ampere. It is given here.
You can write here V equal to 220. V equal to 220. I equal to 5 ampere. So you can substitute the values. So we get 22 into 5 is 110. 0. Right? 1.1 kilowatts. So 1100 watts. So that is also written as 1.1 kilowatts. As I told you earlier, kilo means 1000. Right? Now this is the power. Then determine the power. Second thing is energy consumed in 2 hours. Electric energy. Consume in 2 hours. So that direct you can use VIP, energy consumed is the work done. Work done. Work done is equal to power into time. You see, power is equal to work by time. Work by time. Power is equal to work by time. Therefore, work done is equal to power into time. Power into time is VIT. We also know this. So 220 into 5 into 2 hours, but here it is time in hours, you must convert it into seconds. 2 hours, 2 into 60 minutes into 60 seconds. So you can express this in terms of joules. So we already know this is 1100. 1100 into 6 to the 12. So you can write it as 2200 into 60 into 60. So you can calculate now. 22 into 36. 6 plus 1 7. So 72. Right? 792. 1 2 3 4. 792. Joules. So you can write it as 7920 kilojoules. 7920 kilojoules. In this way, we need to calculate electric energy consumed. So in the next video, we will learn the important unit that is used for measuring the electricity, commercial unit of electrical energy, which is based on the same calculation. That is energy equal to power into time. Kilowatt hour is the commercial unit of electrical energy. So per kilowatt hour of electric energy that is consumed, there is a rate, 3 rupees, 4 rupees. Right? So we will calculate that in the next video. And I will give you one simple problem for your exercise. Quickly look into these two problems. There are two devices here. Which uses more energy? A 250 watt TV set in 1 hour, a 1200 watt toaster in 10 minutes. Which out of these consumes more energy? This is first problem. Second one, there is an electric bulb rated 220 volt 100 watt. 100 watt bulb is there. Rated 220 volt. If this same bulb is operated on 110 voltage supply, if the voltage is reduced to 110, then what is the power consumed by this bulb? So you are asked to calculate this. So these are the two problems. We will discuss more about it and we will solve more problems in the next video. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.